morning, my dear students. Hearty welcome to my English grammar class. Hope you are all fine and are doing well. Before starting the class, let me give you a few words of exhortation. You must love learning because learning is the mother of all virtues. You must devote at least 3 hours of time for learning your lessons at home. Work hard. Respect your teachers. Love your friends and do good to them. Purity, patience and perseverance, that will reach you in the summit of success. That is all for the day. Now, let us start. All of us know that English is an international language. Then, let me ask it. What do you mean by language? I shall give the answer. Language is the medium for the expression and the communication of ideas and experiences. Every day, we communicate our thoughts, our emotions, our experiences, our observations, hopes and fears to others through written language, spoken language, hand signals, gestures, and notes. So, ideas can be expressed either written form or in spoken form. When we speak or when we write, we use words. There are 8 different kinds of words in English language. They are known as parts of speech. There are 8 parts of speech in English. They are noun, pronoun, verb, adjective, adverb, preposition, conjunction and interjection. Once again, I shall repeat. The parts of speech in English are 8 in numbers, and they are noun, pronoun, verb, adjective, adverb, preposition, conjunction, and interjection. A noun is a naming word. Pronoun replaces a noun. It is a word used instead of a noun. Verbs are doing words. Adjectives qualifies the meaning of a noun, or it adds something to the meaning of a noun. It qualifies a noun. Adverbs modify a verb, an adjective, or another adverb. Prepositions, they relate a noun to other words in a sentence. Conjunctions are joining words. We can say it like a piece of grammatical string that joins together other parts. Interjections are exclamations. They show sudden feelings or sudden emotions, strong emotions. Let us see each part one by one. Noun is the name of anything. It can be the name of a person, a place, an object, a feeling, or a quality. For example, name of a person. Gale. Name of a place. Zoo. Name of an object. Book. Name of a feeling. Anger. Name of a quality. Honesty. So, what is a noun? A noun is a naming word. I am going to give you an assignment. Prepare a list of 500 nouns in. Okay. Now, let us come to the other part, pronouns. Pronoun means a noun used instead of a noun. A pronoun replaces a noun in a sentence, just as a voice principle acts for principle, pronouns act for nouns. An example, QB is absent because Joby is ill. This sentence can be written like this. Joby is absent because he is. Instead of Joby, we use he here. He replaces the noun Joby in this sentence. So, a word used instead of a noun to avoid repetition of that same noun is known as a pronoun. I, we, you, he, she, it, they, and like. The different forms of pronoun I are me, my, mine, myself. The different forms of we, us, our, ours. The different forms of you, you, your, yourself. The different forms of he, him, his, himself, she, her, herself, they, them, their, themselves. I shall give you an assignment. Make a list of 10 pronouns in English language. Now, verbs. It is a doing verb or it is a saying verb. It denotes an action. Three main forms of an English verb are base form, past form, past participle form. Example, write, this is the base form. Wrote, this is the past form. And written, this is the past participle form. Another way, eat, ate, eaten. Another way, work, worked, worked. An assignment I shall give. Make a list of 50 words with three main forms, that is base form, and past participle form. We can represent the base form using the symbol V1, past form using the symbol V2, and past participle using the form V3. The base form V1, past form V2, past participle form V3. An example, he reads his lesson. Here, the doing word is read. It shows an action. This is the word in this sentence. Next is the adjective. The word adjective, it adds something to the meaning of a noun. It qualifies a noun. For example, he is a clever boy. The word clever adds something to the meaning of the word boy, or it qualifies the noun boy. Next, adverb. Adverbs modify a verb, an adjective, or another adverb. For example, he runs fast. Here, fast is the adverb that modifies the verb runs. He runs very fast. Here, very modifies the word fast. Very modifies the word fast. Next, he is a very good boy. Here, very, adverb very, modifies the adjective good. He is quite strong. The adverb quite modifies the adjective strong. So, adverbs are words that modify a verb, an adjective, or another adverb. The next one is preposition. Preposition is a word used with a noun or a pronoun to show its relationship with some other words in the sentence. A preposition is a word used with a noun or a pronoun to show its relationship with some other words in the sentence. For example, the book is on the table. Preposition on is placed before the noun book. The word preposition comes from the Latin word preponere, which means to place before. Usually, prepositions are placed before nouns. For example, he sat under a tree. Here, tree is the noun, under is the preposition, it comes before the noun. Prepositions are usually placed before nouns. There are a lot of prepositions in English language. In, on, under, of, at, from, to, by, all these are prepositions. The next one is conjunction. Conjunction. Conjunctions are joining words. They join words or sentences together. A conjunction can be described as a piece of grammatical string that join together. For example, Job and Joey are friends. Job and Joey are friends. Here, and joins Job and Joey. It is a joining word. It is a conjunction. Another example is I did not come because I was ill. Because is the conjunction in this sentence. Another one is they can go by bus or train. Or is the conjunction in this sentence. Another one, he is rich, but he is not happy. He is rich, but he is not happy. Here, but, the word but is the conjunction and it joins he is rich and he is not happy together. So conjunctions are joining words. Now the next part of speech is interjection. Interjections show strong feelings or sudden feelings. They are exclamations. Examples are, hurrah, we have won the match. Alas, the old man died. Ah, what a pleasant scene. Oh, let us dance. Ah, it is very beautiful. Hush, be silent. Examples of interjections. So, we have covered all the 8 parts of speech. Try to find a list of different parts of speech from your experience and textbook. Thank you.